Hello, this is Cristi. In this short video, I'm going to show you one workflow that I use when I publish videos to YouTube, and I make use of two programs to create those videos and edit them and finish them. One of them is Camtasia, so I record my screen with Camtasia. It's very good quality to record, and then editing, zooming in and out, and making all those things, and then the video is finished. So then, after I do this, I export it from Camtasia, and I want to upload it to YouTube. But before I do that, I usually put it into Descript. And this program, Descript, it allows you to transcribe a piece of video or audio into words, and it supports 23 languages, and it allows you to make corrections and improve the text and make text replacements, and also then create subtitles from it, or even export the video from there as well and create new videos, social media videos, and all those things. So today, I want to show you how I finish my Camtasia videos, and I have a project here from Chris Menard, and I've just finished editing his video. The tutorial is done, and as you know, Camtasia does include a way to generate captions, but it's all a manual process, and even integration with Audi8 isn't amazing because of the lack of punctuation and some other functions, plus editing is very slow. So with Descript, actually, so there's a link in the description so you can get transcriptions with Descript, and it includes this amazing interface where you correct your text, you finish it up, and I want to show you today how I auto-fit this subtitle in my YouTube video, because if I upload the video from Camtasia or export from Camtasia and upload to YouTube, that's one export. If I upload it to Descript after finishing Camtasia, and then exporting again from Descript, that's two exports. And I'm not really a fan of encoding a video multiple times. So then I try and finish the video in Camtasia and then just include it in Descript for subtitles editing because it's so much faster. So I have already transcribed this video from Chris here, and I have created the transcript. I've made corrections to it, and the nice thing about YouTube's auto-fit is that you can actually just paste a bunch of text. You don't need to export a subtitle, although you can do this from the publish menu in Descript. You go to export, and then you go here. What do you want to export? The transcript, perhaps, or subtitles. And you can export subtitles in SRT or VTT, which is needed for maybe course platforms like Udemy and Teachable and all those things. And even YouTube allows you to upload the subtitles. The problem with uploading the subtitles is if I've made some cuts in the text here in Descript by removing maybe some filler words or cleaning up some of the words and pauses and things like that, that is technically a different video. So it's got different timings and it may be shorter or longer, whatever I did. So it does no longer correspond in length to the version that I already may have uploaded from Camtasia. So if you upload SRT files or VTT, they have timing information in them and they won't match. But thankfully, YouTube supports AutoSync. So let me show you, it's so easy. You can go here on YouTube, and I've already uploaded this video. It's right here. It's ready to go. We need to put the description in. But if you go to subtitles, you will notice that YouTube has already transcribed this video and created an automatic transcription for subtitles. If I duplicate and edit this, let me show you what it is. You see here, there's no punctuation. There's no breaks, there's nothing. Plus, a lot of the words are actually transcribed wrong because YouTube doesn't really understand always all the words. So honestly, I don't care for this one. So I'm going to just click outside of this, discard the changes. And what I do is I go right here to this menu right next to it and click delete. I'm going to delete this caption that YouTube generated. I want to add my own. So now that I deleted that, my video language is English, so now I can add subtitles for English. Let's go back to Descript, and this is my corrected transcription here. Just Control A or Command A on the Mac, Control C to copy, and then go to YouTube again and click Add Subtitles here. And instead of uploading the file, which is the SRT file or whatever, I'm going to go Auto Sync. You can also type them manually. As the video is playing, you can type them in here if you type fast enough. AutoSync is the easiest way, and it synchronizes your subtitles now with the video with the correct timings. So I'm going to paste this in here, Control V to paste. There is the text. I have some words underlined because I use a extension from Grammarly to suggest changes and things like that. I don't want to make too many changes with that because, you know, I don't want to get too far from what Chris is actually saying on the video. So I am done with this. You know, there's no timing information, but look at this down here. Already YouTube has synchronized it to the audio. So I'm going to click publish now, or before you do that, you can actually try to see if it's doing it right. Click to play.
Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to take a look at something that annoys people.
So as you can see, it's very nice. I've already actually seen a mistake. There we go. You can still make corrections in here before you synchronize this. And then when you're done, just click publish. So YouTube actually tells you that it takes a bunch of hours or minutes to clean it up, to synchronize it. But look, this one, this time it's been quite fast. It says it's published. So if I go now, let's see if the video is already including that on the live website.
Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to take a look at something that annoys people.
So there it is. The subtitle works very well and it looks very nice and it's synchronized. And this is how I do all of my subtitles on YouTube, by using Descript to transcribe and correct this and then putting it on the YouTube. And if you do this actually, and if we go to other videos from Chris, you will notice that because you upload your own subtitles this way, YouTube now shows subtitles here next to each video. We seem to have missed this one though. We'll have to fix that. But you see, all the videos show you that they have captions or subtitles. So someone who comes along and wants to watch your video with a subtitle in a different language, you can still use the translation feature automatically. So if you go to a video
in Microsoft Excel,
and you go to the subtitles down here, you can turn them on and off. But if you go to the settings, you see the subtitles here, English, and I'm still, sometimes YouTube just puts the auto-generated ones back, but I can click auto-translate and let's choose something like French. So there you go. The subtitles are automatically translated from the ones you uploaded, not from the automatic ones.
When doing pivot tables, you have this really...
So this is very nice because I have talked to someone at YouTube and they actually confirmed that YouTube also looks in these subtitles for keywords for your, you know, the topic of your video to figure out what's in it and so on. And they said, yes, if you upload them, that also helps. So there you go. A quick tip. I'm not a person who gets stuck on just one program for anything, so I use Camtasia a lot. I use Descript a lot too every day. So these two programs are really great, and correction in Descript is very, very easy to do. And I have some tutorials on my channel about this, and I also finished a course for Descript Storyboard, the new version. If you want to check that out, it's in the description there. So thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.